Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to solve the welding connection examples. So first example is about to check the safety of joint. So here there is a problem. So first we will read the problem, we will try to understand the problem, and then we will solve this problem. So the problem is there are two plates of 16 mm and 14 mm thickness, which means these thickness are of the plates are of unequal thickness, and they are to be joined by a groove joint. Groove weld joint, as shown in the figure. So there you can see there are the figure. The joint is subjected to a factored tensile force of 430 kilonewton. So this joint, these joints are subjected to the factored tensile force. Both of these joints are subjected to factor tensile force, and which is 430 kilonewton. Now, due to some reasons, now it mentions, due to some reasons, the effective length of the weld that could be provided was 175 mm only. So because of some reason, we can only provide this much length of weld in the joint. So now it says we have to check the safety of joint if we provide single V groove weld and double V groove weld. So we have to check which joint will be safe. So first is single V groove weld. So in the first figure you can see this these two plates are joined using this single V groove weld, and the second one is where we have provided double V groove weld. So we will check the safety. We will try to find out the load carrying capacity of these two plates, and we will see which one is safe and which one can carry 430 kilonewton load safely. So in this problem, we are going to check the safety of joint with these two types of groove weld. One is the single V and the second one is double V groove weld. And in the last point, it says, assuming the plates to be shop welded. So basically I told you that there are two types of weld that we generally use. One is the shop weld and the other one is field weld. So in the shop weld, we generally weld the sections in a controlled environment where the quality control is good and we can ensure the quality of weld properly. But in case of field weld, if there is a field weld, then it is a little difficult to control the quality control of the weld. So that is why sometimes field weld are considered inferior to the shop weld. And that is why we take more safety factor in case of field weld. While in case of shop welded, we can trust the quality, and in that case, we can take less amount of partial safety factor. So how much partial safety factor we need to take, that I will show you using the table. So all those values are given in the IS code. So we will see that. So first, our first step is to write the given data. So whenever we start our numerical, first we need to make the diagram, and then if diagram is already provided, then what we do is we try to write the given data. Whichever data is given, we need to write that. So now I will be writing the solution. So in the solution, we will write given data. So given data is first thing is the thickness of plate is given. So plate thickness. So plate thickness, so these are two unequal thickness plate. So first plate thickness is 16 mm, and the other plate thickness is 14 mm. Okay, so first data which is provided in the numerical is the plate thickness. Then the next data which is already provided in the numerical was the factored load. Factored load. Well, I hope you know factored load is the load which is already calculated using the partial safety factor. So factored load is given already in the problem, and which is 430 kilonewton. So this much load is to be applied on this joint. And another data which is given in the problem is the effective length of weld. So there you can already see that this one is already provided, which is effective length, load is given, and thickness is provided. So effective length of weld, effective length of weld will be 175 mm. So this much length of weld can be provided in this joint. So effective length of weld, generally we denote effective length of weld by say LW. And other things which are already which are not given in this, so sometimes you may not be given the plate grade in the numerical. So in that case, we generally assume the grade of plate as Fe415. So I'm assuming here plate grade, and I am assuming it. So if it is not given in the numerical, I also suggest you to assume this grade only, because 99% in the steel work we use this grade of plate, which is Fe410. So Fe stands for ferric, 410 is the ultimate strength of the plate. So ultimate strength of plate means the value of Fu will be 410 MPa or Newton per mm square. And ultimate strength can be given with this. Also, if we try to find out the yield strength, which is Fy, yield strength of the plate. So generally this yield strength is about 60%. It is approximately 60% of this value. So we will write here. So 60% of 410 is approximately 244 or 246. So generally it is taken as equivalent to 250 MPa. So this plate has Fu value 410 and Fy value as 250 MPa or Newton per mm square. Okay. So we have already assumed it. Now, if the grade of plate is mentioned other than Fe410 in the numerical, then we will take that. If it is not given in the numerical, then we will assume this grade only, Fe410. And this is the grade of actually mild steel. So mild steel plates are generally used in the steel work. Now we will consider our case one. So first we will consider case one, which is case A. And in case A, single V groove weld is provided. So when we use case one, in this you can see single V groove weld is used. So now I have already mentioned in the lecture, so I will show you here. Generally in the single V or single U or single J joint, generally incomplete penetration, you can see here, incomplete penetration is considered. Generally effective throat thickness for the calculation purpose is taken as 5/8. Now why do we need to have this effective throat thickness? Because we need to find out the strength of weld. So because there is a groove weld that we are using and force applied is tensile force. So there you can see it says 430 kilonewton tensile force. So tensile strength of groove weld can be given as, so I'm writing here, tensile strength. First I'm writing the case. This is our case A. This is our case A. When we are using single V groove weld. Okay, so in the case of single V groove weld, tensile strength of groove weld can be given as so in this case, the tensile strength will be TdW is equals to LW into TE into Fy upon gamma MW. I will show you this formula in the lecture which I have already covered with in the previous part. So there you can see the formula. So the design strength of butt weld in tension or compression is given by Fy LW into TE upon gamma MW. So why we are taking tensile force or tensile strength? Because the joint is subjected to 430 kN tensile force. It is already mentioned in the numerical. It says the joint is subjected to a factored tensile force. So that is why we are checking the tensile strength of the joint. And for that, tensile strength formula will be this. So there, LW is already provided in the numerical, which is the effective length of weld, which is 175. There you can see 175. And TE. Now, what is TE? TE is the throat thickness. Throat thickness. So throat thickness for single V will be taken as now I will show you that which I have written. So there you can see in the single V groove weld, generally incomplete penetration is considered. Why incomplete penetration? Now I will show you that in the diagram also. So there you can see the penetration is complete up to this thickness, but what about this one? There is a root where the weld material is not reaching. So that is why we generally consider the fraction of thickness of thinner plate as the throat thickness. So I have already mentioned that in case of incomplete penetration butt weld. So generally single V is considered as incomplete penetration. And in that case, the throat thickness, it says for the purpose of stress calculation, the effective throat thickness should not exceed 5 × 8 of the thickness of thinner part. Thickness of thinner part. So now in our case, the thinner part is 14 mm. So 5 × 8 × 14 mm will be the throat thickness in single V groove weld. So now I'm writing here throat thickness TE will be equals to 5 × 8 × thickness of thinner part or thinner plate, and thinner plate is 14 mm thick. So we will write here 5 × 8 multiplied by 14. So there we get the value of TE as 8.75. So that is our throat thickness for single V groove weld, which is 5 by 8 times of thickness of the thinner plate. If the thickness of both plate will be same, then we would take any thickness, but here the thickness difference is there. Yes, one thing I forgot to tell you, there is a difference between the thickness. This is 16 and this is 14. Well, this difference should not be more than 3 mm or 25%. Whichever is more. So this is also I have already mentioned in the numerical. Here you can see, there you can see the difference in thickness between the two plates should not be more than 25% of the thickness or 3 mm, whichever is more. So there in our case, you can see the thickness is less than 25% as well as less than 3 mm. So that is why I have not provided any taper, because it says if difference is more than 25%, then generally we provide a taper 1 in 5, which looks like this. So this kind of taper you can see here. So this kind of taper is generally provided when the thickness difference is more than 3 mm or 25%, whichever is more. So because in our case, thickness difference is 2 mm only. So 2 mm is less than 3 mm, and it is also less than the 25%. So 25% of 16 will be 4 mm. Okay, so 4 mm, the difference is 2 mm only. So in both case, it is less than 3 mm and 25%. So that is why I am not considering any tapering. So that is why we directly performing our numerical by writing this formula. Okay, so now our throat thickness is calculated. Now the value of Fy I just written here. So there you can see the Fy value of the plate is 250 MPa, which is 60% of the Fu value of this plate. So Fy is also given. So now we can simply find out. Yes, one thing is missing, which is gamma Mw. Well, gamma Mw is the partial safety factor for welded connections. So as it is already mentioned that the plate is shop welded. The plate is shop welded. So for the shop welded connections, the partial safety factor will be 1.25. We can check that using the IS code also. So there in the IS code on page number 30, there are given the partial safety factor for material, which is gamma M. Now I am using gamma Mw. Why? Because there you can see for welded connection, we represent partial safety factor as gamma Mw. And corresponding to this, in the shop fabrication, the value of gamma Mw will be 1.25, while in case of field fabrication, the value of weld will be 1.5. As I told you earlier, that in the field, the quality of weld is not good. It is inferior to the shop weld. So that is why, to ensure more safety, we take more partial safety factor in case of field weld. So, but in our case, the weld is a shop weld. So in our case, gamma Mw will be, I'm writing here, gamma Mw will be 1.25 because our welding is shop welding. So now we got all the values. So we will try to find out the tensile strength now. So tensile strength will be TDW is equals to LW is already mentioned, which is 175 mm multiplied by throat thickness. We just calculated 8.75 multiplied by the value of Fy is 250 MPa, and the value of gamma Mw, it will be 1.25. And if I multiply the whole value with 10 raised to power minus 3, then I will be able to get this strength directly in the kilonewton. If I don't multiply this with 10 raised to power minus 3, then I will get the value in newton, because you can see 250 is newton, the unit of 250 is newton per mm square. 8.75 is in the mm, 175 is in the mm, and 1.25, it is a constant value. So as 250 is in newton per mm square, so we will get the value in newton. But if I multiply this by 10 raised to power minus 3, then I will directly get the value in kilonewton. So after this calculation, the value of TDW, which is the tensile strength, this TDW comes out as 306.25 kilonewton. So in case of single V groove weld, if we provide single V groove weld, then the strength of this joint in tension will be 306.25 kilonewton. But in the question, it is mentioned that we need to design our joint to carry this much load. So now you can see we need to design this joint, or we need to check the safety of this joint, if it can carry 430 kilonewton load or not. So with this, we can conclude that The tensile strength of single V groove weld is 306 and which is less than 430 kilonewton. So in this case, we can say that the joint is not safe. Joint is inadequate and not safe. So first case is failing. It will not be able to carry this much load. So now we will move to our next case, which is when we provide double V groove weld. If we provide double V groove weld like this, can it carry 430 kilonewton? So again, we have to check this again. So now I'm mentioning the case B. If we refer to case B, case B, and in this case we are using double V groove weld. So in this case we are using double V groove weld, and in the lecture I have mentioned that all the double V or double U or double J, they are considered as the completely penetrated butt weld. In case of a single V or single J, they are considered as the partially penetrated. But if we use the double V or double U, they are considered as the completely penetrated butt weld or groove weld. In the figure also, you can see that this part is not covered with the welding. But in this case, you can see the whole thickness is covered with the welded material. So in that case, the throat thickness will be equivalent to the thickness of thinner part. And it is also mentioned in the lecture. There you can see the effective throat thickness in case of complete penetration is taken as the thickness of the thinner part. So you can easily say and see this. So I will be writing here effective throat thickness in this case. Effective throat thickness in this case will be equivalent to the thickness of thinner part, which is 14 mm. Other values will be same. So now in this case, if we try to get the tensile strength, TDW will be equivalent to LW into TE multiplied by FY upon gamma MW. So in that case, now we will put the value 175 multiplied by 14 mm. In this case, we have 14 mm as the throat thickness, complete throat thickness, multiplied by 250 by 1.25. So in that case, if we try to find, I mean, again, I am multiplying this with the 10 raised to power minus 3 so that I can get the value in the kilonewton directly. So in this case, the value comes out as 490. So value is 490 kilonewton. 490 kilonewton. And now you can see this value is greater than the required tensile force, which is 430 kilonewton. So we need to check the safety of both of these joints, and we can say that in the second case, if we provide the double V joint, then the strength of joint will be, tensile strength of the joint will be 490, and it can safely carry this much load. So we can say that the joint is adequate and is safe. So this concludes our numerical solution. Thank you.